Hey guys, we have discussed the drawbacks of this SJF algorithm, shortage of first, that is, it is not implementable. And why so? Because the main criteria in this algorithm is burst time, and the operating system doesn't know the actual burst time of the process prior to its execution, that how much time it is going to take for its execution. That is almost impossible to know. Okay, but we can predict using some methods, we can predict the approximate burst time of the process, that how much time it is going to take for its execution, approximate time. Okay, so in this video I'm going to tell you those methods. First of all, we'll discuss the simple methods. I'm not saying that we can predict the actual burst time, but we can predict the approximate burst time, and sometimes these methods work and sometimes these methods don't work. Okay, now the first two method is, we can predict the burst time of a process based on the process size and process type. The first is process size. See, let us take one example. One process was there which has completed its execution, and the size of that process was 100 KB, and that process suppose took 5 units of time for its execution, 5 units. And suppose new process is there, P new, which is having 102 KB, size is 102 KB. So we can predict that this process will also take the burst time, or you can say this process will also take approximate 5 units of time for its execution. Why so? Because the old process was the size of that process was 100 KB, that very nearby to this size, and that process took 5 unit of time, so this process will also took around 5 unit of time. See, sometimes this method works, sometimes this method doesn't work. Why so? Because the time taken by a process also depends on the type of the process, the nature of the process. Okay, so we cannot say that in case size is same, then that process is going to take approximate the same time to complete its execution. Okay, let us take one example. Suppose you want to go from Delhi to Mumbai, and approximate distance is around, I guess, 1500 kilometer. So see, one person has opted the transport way of transportation through flight, and the time taken is approximate 2 hours. And one person is going through train, so the time taken would be approximate 20 hours. Fine. And one person is going maybe through its own vehicle or car or bus, something like a car. Okay. And that would take maybe approx 52 hours. So see, the distance is same, 1500 kilometer, but here time taken is different. Why so? Because of the nature of the transportation the person has opted, the flight, train or car. That is why the burst time also depends on the nature or the type of the process. We cannot say that if size is approximately same, then it is going to take the same burst time. Okay, sometimes these method work, sometimes they don't work. Okay, now next method is averaging method. Okay, let us take 5 processes are there which has completed its execution. So if these processes has completed its execution, so we know the actual burst time of these processes, so how much time these processes took for its execution. Okay, now this one is from suppose T1, this one is T2, this one has taken T3, T4 and T5. So for P6, for incoming process, for the next process P6, you can predict the burst time. How? Just simply add these burst time and divide it by the number of processes, that is 5. Simply do calculate the average of the previous processes. Okay, or generally you can write that 1 by n summation of I is equal to 1 to n and T of I. This T is what? Ti is what? Actual burst time of a process, Pi. Okay, so this is the simple averaging method. Now next method is what? So the next method is exponential averaging, and this is the formula. ei plus 1 is equal to alpha a of I plus 1 minus alpha e of I. Now here ei of I plus 1 is what? The expected burst time of for the process I plus 1. And ai is what? Actual burst time of process I. Alpha is smoothing factor. And this alpha will range from 0 to 1. Fine. Now see, the expected time of the process depends on the actual burst time of the previous process and the expected time of that process. Or you can say the actual burst time and the expected time of the previous process. On these two factors, this expected time of the next process depends, plus also this alpha factor. Okay. Now, see, if you want to write this ei, then how you can write this ei would be alpha actual time of the previous process, that is I minus 1, plus 1 minus alpha expected time of the previous process, that is I minus 1. Fine. And now how to calculate this expected time? You have to calculate this expected time of the previous process. Now if you continue this one, then e of I plus I minus 1 would be alpha a of I minus 2 previous one plus 1 minus alpha e of I minus 2. And this would go on till the initial process. The first, very first process, initial process. So that is why we can say that the expected time of a process depends on the history, or you can say that actual burst time and the expected time of the previous processes, all the previous processes, fine, using this method. Okay, now what is this alpha? See, you can take this alpha from 0 to 1, okay, but generally alpha is not taken either 0 or 1. Why so? Because if you take alpha is equal to 0, see, if alpha is equal to 0 and you will put the value 0 here, then this would become 0 and this 1 minus alpha 1 minus 0 is 1, that is e of I. So we can say that the expected time of the process depends on the expected time of the previous process, totally on the expected time of the previous process. Here the actual burst time of the previous process doesn't matter, but that is not true actually. Okay, ultimately when you solve this one, ei, then you will go to ei minus 1, then ei minus 2 and so on, and you will go to the initial process. So that is why you can say that the expected time of the process depends on the expected time of the initial process. Okay, and if you take alpha is equal to 1, in that case what will happen? This would become 0, alpha 1, 1 minus 1, 0, and this would become 1, a of I. So you can say that the expected time of a process depends on the actual burst time of the previous process. Like suppose you are calculating for P5 and alpha is equal to 1, then it totally depends on the actual burst time of P4. That is very dynamic. Okay, so that is also not good. So alpha would be in the range of 0 to 1, that is, it would be better, it will take alpha is in between 0 to 1, that is 0.5. You are going to give weightage to this also and to this also, half weightage when alpha is 0.5. So this is basically known as the weighting factor, or you can say that smoothing factor. Okay, now let us take one example. As you are given the value of alpha, this would always be given if you are asked such type of question, that is 0.5, and the expected time of the initial process E1 is 5, and 4 processes are given and actual burst time of these processes has been given, and you have to calculate E of 5, that is expected or the predicted burst time of the process 5, P5. Okay, now how you will calculate? Now for when you put the value here only for E5, what you have to know? The actual burst time of the previous process. For E5, you have to know the actual burst time of the process P4 plus the expected time of the process P4. Now here the expected time of the initial process is given, only the initial process. The expected time of P4 is not given. You have to calculate expected time of P4. How you will calculate? You will expand this formula like this. P3, then P2, then P1, and finally expected time of P1 is given, that is 5. So this is how you will calculate. Now using this formula, how you can write E of 5 would be, see, alpha is what? 0.5. 0.5 into actual burst time of previous process. Okay. So actual burst time of previous process is what? See, if you are calculating for E5, then here you will write what? A, actual burst time of the process, 4. And for P4, burst time is what? 6. Plus 1 minus alpha, that is 0.5, into expected time of previous process. Expected time of previous, that is 4. E4. Now here you will write E4, but E4 is not given. You have to calculate now E4. Now what is E4? See, E4 would be alpha into actual burst time of the previous process. That is actual burst time of the process P3. This one is into 5 plus 1 minus alpha into expected time of process 3. But this is not given. So you have to calculate E3 also. Now E3 would be what? Alpha actual burst time of P2, that is 8, plus 1 minus alpha and the expected time of E2, but that is also not given. Calculate for E2, alpha actual burst time of P1, that is 4, plus 1 minus alpha is 0.5, and here E of 1, the expected time of previous process. That is, here is 2, so here you will get the previous process, that is 1, and then E1 is given, that is 5. So we can put even 5 here and we can calculate this value. So this value would be what? This would be 4.5. Now you know the value of E2, you can put this 4.5 in this equation and calculate this value, and this value would be plus 0.5 into 4.5, 0.5 into 4.5, and this value would be 6.25. Now put this value E3 in this equation and find out E4. This would be 0.5 into 6.25, and this value would be 5.625. Now calculate the value of E5. Put this value here and find out the value. So finally this value would be approximate 5.81. So E5 would be 5.81. So here you can write the expected time for the process P5 would be 5.81. And see, we have calculated this value using this formula, and this is known as exponential averaging formula. So this is how you can predict the burst time of any process based on the actual burst time of the previous process plus the expected time of the previous process. But this is not, you know, practically used. One more thing I want to tell you is, see, when the arrival, see, I have discussed SJF with non-preemption and SJF with preemption, that is SRTF. So when the arrival time of all the processes is same, then SRTF will act as SJF with non-preemption. When arrival time of all the processes is same, either you can say 00000, or maybe same is 111 or 222 like this, but the condition is arrival time must be same. In that case, SRTF will act same as SJF with known preemption. Okay, so I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.